we can't jump to the conclusion that this is, you know, pieces of the plane or not. But I know that once, you know, you really can examine the debris, you can really figure out if this is the plane, how it hit the water, sort of backtracking that way. Can you just walk me through, as an accident investigator, how one would approach even examining the debris?
Well, there's you know, items on the macro scale or the large scale that we'd be looking at, but also things on the micro scale. So they'd be looking at how the metal is deformed, what part of the airplane, the way that it's bent, the angles. But then also for some of the items, they're going to want to look at some of the smaller cracks and some of the smaller lesions and so forth that might be telling also. The bottom line is you have to get the wreckage in your hand and then decide what level that you feel like or they feel like they're going to need to look at it.
Let's say, and we know this isn't going to happen, but for the sake of conversation, they go out there and they find this debris and have this in their hand tomorrow. So that's 3 weeks that it's been sitting and floating, you know, with marine life and seawater. Would that damage it at all?
Well, yeah, absolutely. And there certainly will be some damage. And it depends on what type of metal we're talking about, steel versus aluminum versus some of the plastic material that might be out there. But one of the things that they're going to be looking at, and one of the things that's a significant part of this investigation that needs to be ruled out eventually, is looking for fire and soot and other evidence of a pre-impact fire very well still may be on the wreckage. So it doesn't rule out the ability to see that type of evidential clue.
Kit Darby, we know that they're looking ultimately, we're talking about the debris field because they want to trace it back to the plane to finally find the black box to figure out what exactly happened. Is it possible, if you're flying a plane though, and you're in the cockpit, and I'm not saying, we don't know if anything nefarious happened, but could you mess with the black box, or is it perfectly intact, safe, no one can change it?
No, there's no excess from the cockpit.
There isn't.
At the most, a circuit breaker, which could turn it off. But it's way in the back of the plane. It's back there for a reason, to protect it from crash impact forces.
In the tail section.
Yeah, so it's going to be attached to, I mean, some people worry about it sinking to the bottom and being lost in the ooze or
right,
attenuating its signal. It's going to typically be attached to a large piece of airplane, which would, even in the gooeyest bottom, sit on the top of it at least for a while and give us a fair chance to find it.
What about the cockpit voice reporter?
Same location, same rules.
Okay.